Did you ever envision it going this long? Just that streak?
Ah, no, you kind of know, you just take it one meet at a time when it gets to be up there. That's just a bummer, man. I feel like I'm in a lot better place than that I showed in. Just didn't go my way today. It's a tough place that I've had to, you know, had to have it here, because Drake's pretty special to me, so, you know, I wanted to go out on a high note. I mean, in all reality, this is probably my last US Champs at Drake Stadium. You know what I mean? I don't know when they're going to have it again, and at that point, you know, I don't know where I'm going to be, so. That's a bummer, man. You know, you just put in so much work, and, you know, when you get, like, some setbacks, and you don't get the kind of training that you need to, I was really hoping that with these races, I was going to get in a better rhythm, and, you know, just, I wanted to put myself in the final. I mean, I took it out hard. You know, I was thinking I could run the standard today. It was the goal. I'm not sure about it on Sunday. And, you know, I was there for 600, 700 meters. And, man, I just announced it.
How fun's it been?
Oh, it's been awesome, man, you know? But at the same point, you know, I'm not trying to look at this as like a farewell tour, you know what I mean? I mean, I still think, you know, next year's a huge year. And I think that I've shown, you know, when I'm healthy, I can kind of compete with anyone going through the rounds. So, like I said, it's a bummer that it had to happen here. But, you know, get back on the horse, like, it's more races in the summer. And then, you know, just you get healthy and get a good build up going into winter.
Have you had injury problems this year, though?
Yeah, man, this has been I was telling these guys yesterday, this has been the toughest year for me. I wasn't able to run any track workouts between Christmas and, like, 5 days before Dr. Sanders. I mean, I ran that whole indoor season off of cross training. So I was kind of trying to race myself into shape there. You know, I had a good build up. I ran pretty well. My last race in Germany, I went 146.2 lead wire to wire, and then next week I was just kind of doing some plyos, and I tweaked my ligaments in my back like 3.5 weeks ago, and that just hasn't gotten to be 100%. I mean, I've probably been on the track, you know, 7-10 days since then, and I finally started to kind of find a rhythm. But even then, I mean, I was kind of just back up against the wall. I mean, I wasn't putting together, you know, back-to-back workouts like I would have had to do today, you know, back-to-back races. So yeah, I mean, it sucks. I've never been in this position before, you know what I mean, to miss your first final. It hurts. I mean, I got a lot of family, a lot of friends here, you know, that had tickets for Sunday, so that's kind of a bummer. But like I said, I mean, you know, the streak was going to get broken at some point. Get back on the horse, we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Do you feel like you pretty much ran, it seemed like you ran how you, the best you could do today. Like, do you have any regrets or anything?
No, not at all. I mean, 51.5 generally for me is pretty easy, you know, and like I said, I just don't think the rhythm was there. I mean, I just never felt good from, you know, 650 to 800 in one of those races yesterday today, and you know, I was just hoping that I was going to feel better than I did, and like I said, man, it sucks. I mean, doing this for so long, you know, you don't think that streak's going to end, and you know, just, I'm at the track, you know, every day on my own, you're just putting in that work, putting in that work, putting in the work, and it's a lot of things, you know, people don't see when you're banged up. I mean, you go to practice, sometimes the coach is gone with the team for 4 weeks, you know, I'm out at the track by myself, just kind of trudging through things and going home, and I'm probably miserable there, and, you know, I feel about that, bad about that, but, yeah, I mean, that sucks, and so health, you know, definitely not something you take for granted, and like I said, hopefully I can, you know, get back on the horse and get some good races in the rest of the year.
Still live in Iowa City.
Yeah, yeah, you have to still in Iowa City, still working with Joey, man. Joey's been great for everything. But like I said, I mean, I still think we, like, couple of good years in the tank. You know, this definitely didn't show where I can be. You know, the fitness just wasn't there, and it sucks that it had to happen this time of year.
I think I read that right when you got out of school, this was quite a journey for you. Like, you had an actual, like, job at it.
Yeah. I mean, it was kind of, you know, the transition from high school to college was interesting. I mean, I was set on going to a D3 school, and then I kind of took off the end of my senior year. I got, you know, pennies on the dollar to go to Iowa, but, you know, it was an opportunity I couldn't pass up. And then out of college, you know, I was going to go to med school. Pushed that off a year. I was working 40 hours a week, and you know, the rest of it took off. And you know, I love Iowa State. The people there have been great. You know, there's a lot of them here in the house, so I just, you know, it's a bummer I couldn't put on a bigger show for them.
You were working in a shoe store, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Will you watch the final from the stands?
Probably. It'll be hard, but you know, these guys are awesome. You race against these guys so many times for so many years, and it's exciting to see Haroon make a final. I mean, I've been racing against Haroon since 2009. You know, he's had a couple of rough goes out there, and you know, so I'm pumped for a guy like that. I mean you're looking at the last three NCAA champions, who, I mean, hypothetically all three of those guys could have a chance to medal in Doha. So I mean, we're gonna have a huge great contingency of guys going to Doha. It'll be interesting to see how the race plays out, you know, who comes out on top.
Decide to try to start another streak.
Yeah, you know, that's the plan. I mean, like I said, I just want to get some more training, get some good races in the rest of the summer. I just, you know, I've probably put in about half the races this year than I usually have at this point. And like I said, I mean, man, I love to race. You know, I'm a competitor, and I think that's why this hurts so much. It's just that I'm harder on myself than anybody else is. I mean, I'm going to go out there, and, you know, coach is going to try to talk me down. But, man, this one's going to hurt for a while.
I know you like to race. Obviously, you read David's article about how much you race. I mean, if you ever did have the opportunity, you know, financially or whatever, to scale back your races,
yeah,
you know, how do you think that would impact your peak performance and how much better you could be, if at all?
I don't know. I mean, I think that, you know, there are guys that just get better the more that they race, and I think that I'm just one of those guys, and that's the thing that has helped me. And I mean, I think, you know, making a couple world championship teams, I mean, that helped me financially, so I'm not in a place where I need to race 30 times a year, but I mean, I think when we can set it up well enough with the training, it just kind of gets me out of, you know, the monotony of training day in and day out. And I think that for me, you know, a race is just as good as any workout I can do, so yeah, I don't think I scale back a ton.
Mm-hmm. Is that connected just to training by yourself?
So yeah, you know, I mean, day, you know, like I said, I mean, there's times where I won't see Joey for 4 weeks, but I've done this for so long that it doesn't bother me. Obviously, this year it kind of sucks, you know, being banged up and not having someone at practice, just kind of...
It's literally just you when you go out?
A lot of times, yeah, it's just me. You know, I haven't had a training partner since college. One of my buddies moved to Iowa City, and he's training with me a little bit, but he's a volunteer, so it's not on the team, so when the team's gone, he's gone. So, yeah, a lot of times it's just, you know, me at the track, but... I mean, that didn't take away from anything that happened today, you know what I mean? I've done that for so long that, you know, the workouts just weren't there to see, and I think it, you know, shot.
Appreciate it, Eric.